honorable ministers and senior government officials, representatives of the United Nations agencies here present, members of the newly elected Bureau who are sitting here at the top table, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, as we conclude our deliberations of the sixth session of the African Regional Forum for Sustainable Development, I would like to begin by thanking the African member states for according Zimbabwe the opportunity to host this auspicious event. It was indeed a great honor for us to welcome you all to Zimbabwe and Victoria Falls in particular. Zimbabwe is indeed humbled by the fantastic turnout for this event and hope that we met your expectations in our role as the host nation. We reaffirm today our commitment that Zimbabwe will always stand ready to play a part in providing a comfortable and conducive environment for fruitful deliberations on the all-important subject of advancing the development agendas of Africa. Allow me also to thank the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa in collaboration with the African Union Commission, the African Development Bank, and the United Nations system for bringing this event to Zimbabwe. The presence of the Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, Her Excellency Ms. Amina Mohammed, and the Under Secretary General of the United Nations and Executive Secretary of UNECA, Ms. Vera Songwe, and other senior African Union and United Nations officials shows that the quest to transform Africa has reached another level. Indeed, 2020 to 2030 should be the decade to deliver a transformed and prosperous Africa through the 2030 agenda and Agenda 2016. We need to recover lost time and accelerate achievement of the 17 SDGs and Agenda 2063. Distinguished participants, I think we will all agree that this forum has provided a firm launchpad for the decade of action as we seek to accelerate the implementation of programs towards the attainment of the 2030 Agenda and Agenda 2063. The time for action is now, and Africa has to unite and work together to achieve this decade of action. The words of the founding father of Ghana, and indeed the founding father of what we now call the African Union, Kwame Nkrumah, remain relevant today, that we must unite or perish. We note with satisfaction that the forum engaged in comprehensive and intense deliberations on all the 17 SDGs and corresponding Agenda 2063 goals under the five sub-themes of people, peace, prosperity, planet, and partnership. We are proud to be associated with the outcome document, the Victoria Falls Declaration that we have adopted here, and its ambitious work plan, which we believe should find traction in future forums for sustainable development. As the incoming chair, I wish to commit myself to work with the new Bureau and all stakeholders to ensure that we realize the commitments and promises we have made here in Victoria Falls. It is my hope that future generations seeking to follow the development path of Africa will find value in the Victoria relationship and the outcomes of this conflict. Some of the key messages from the forum include the call for member states to adopt social safety nets to reduce poverty and the need to harness local resources in our quest to achieve the two agendas. The mainstreaming of the Agenda 2030 and Agenda 2063 in the national plans at all levels and the need for disaggregated data to track implementation progress was also highlighted. Let us therefore redouble our efforts in making local innovation in the highlighted areas. The calls for an inclusive approach to governance to enable people-centered dialogue and the engagement and involvement of all stakeholders, including the youth, women, and other marginalized groups in the planning and implementation of socio-economic development programs was very commendable. The Victoria Falls Declaration has very clear and succinct recommendations that have come out of this forum. What is left now is to go full throttle into the implementation while ensuring that no one and no place is left behind. Now is the time to positively change the narrative for Africa. This should start from Victoria Falls, and yes, we can transform the continent. We want Africa to rise Africa and shine. As the host, I urge you to utilize the remaining time. I know it's very little. I wish you could actually stay and go after this coming weekend so that you can continue to enjoy the magnificence of the majestic Victoria Falls or Mosiatunu and other places of interest around the falls. You have my assurances that Zimbabwe can sustainably and transparently utilize the money that you're going to leave here. Victoria Falls' economy has benefited from your spending, and please continue to spend until you leave. At this point in time, ladies and gentlemen, I declare the sixth session of the African Regional Forum for Sustainable Development officially closed, and wish you safe travel back to your various destinations. I would like to call on the Almighty to bless Africa and to blossom Africa. Shine, motherland, shine, Africa. I thank you.
Asking ECA colleagues to come to the podium, we take a group photo. All ECA colleagues.